There's something I want to talk to you about. You wanted to speak to me?
I must speak with you.
What's up?
Of Morcant. Well, suspected, but did not know. Morcant's sorcery was great, greatest perhaps, but his heart torn. Never satisfied, always craving more, more power, too much. Now you go to meet with Serenica. Gift for you.
Get us into Serenica's tower, will it? Thank you very much, Elder Eegoltap.
Send regards to Serenica. Eegoltaps. Regards.
I've been thinking.
I must speak with you.
Hmm.
I don't know if I've mentioned it before, but...
You know, I've been thinking.
Listen.
I've been thinking.
Let's have a nice little chat.
Listen up, laddie.
Hello.
What? That's grand. Let's go and meet Serenica, shall we? Come on, laddie. We've a date with destiny.
Could it be...
How awful! Maybe... Serenica.
Serenica? This is not a name I know. State your purpose here.
The Dark One has returned, and, well, we need you to give us the power to save the world.
Save the world.
Do you remember this, Serenica? This was your flute.
I know it. But from where? The memory is faint. It is there. And yet, the flute I remember was different, mightier. It can play but one melody. But it is a great one. A sacred one. A song of awakening. A song handed down through the years.
I think we know that song. Veronica? Rejoice! Rejoice! The time is come! Arise! Awaken, Holy One!
We offer unto you the skies.
Fly free once more! Arise! Arise!
Cetacea, darling, you're looking just fabulous. A vision. Literally.
Long have I waited. Since the time of Erdwin. Since the last great clash with Calasmos.
She spoke to us.
Shh.
I think she's trying to tell us something.
But know this. The Dark One is powerful beyond imagining. A trial awaits you. Beneath once mighty Zwaardsrust, a means to test thy mettle ere the final fight begins. Go to him. Go to Drustan. And when the time comes, when you would pierce the wall that guards him, I stand ready to. to serve thee.
Ah, a wee practice scrap or two before the main event sounds like just what we need. I reckon we could do worse than pay Zwaardsrust a visit.
He's right. This is one battle we can't be too prepared for. Let's go get fighting fit before we take him down.
Okay.
Wish to speak with me.
Are you all right?
One moment, if you would. Huh? Honored luminary, will you permit me and my daughter a few minutes alone? Despite Mordigan's machinations, my subjects have remained content. My kingdom has remained free of undue suffering. Alas, you, my dear, were not so lucky. I cannot help but wonder how things might have been if I had remained by your side on that fateful day. Perhaps Mordigan would not have possessed me. Perhaps I would not have missed all those years with my beloved daughter. If only I had been better, stronger. Perhaps I could have resisted him. You were meant to know only peace, to be the princess of a great kingdom, blissfully ignorant of the woes of the world. But no, instead, you fought. But you have fought enough. It is time to come home, to claim your birthright, to live in peace and privilege here with me in Heliodor.
Oh, Father. I wouldn't change any of it. I wouldn't change a single day. I've been traveling now for many years, searching for something, meaning, I suppose. And it's been hard, sometimes unbearably so. But it was worth it. I found what I was looking for in the end. You, Father, Rab, my friends, the people of Heliodor, all the people of Erdrea, in fact. These are what give life meaning, and they need protecting. And I'll do whatever it takes to protect them. All of them.
Oh. Yes. You do your kingdom and your father proud. I had thought to save this for the day you took the throne. But I see now that it is time. The tiara is very precious. It once belonged to your mother.
Thank you, Father. It's beautiful.
Now go. Do what you must do. And when all is ended, and peace has returned, you must come home to us, to Heliodor.
Of course. I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, aye! Just the person I wanted to talk to.
Listen.
Did you want to talk to me?
Thank you. Thank you.